Hello friends, welcome you all to this session of environment, where we are going to discuss about some basic terms, aspects and impacts, and how they affect the design of the environment management system. Now, aspects are activities, products and services of any organization that may interact with the environment. So those things are called as aspect. For example, running of the DG set is an aspect. If you are carrying some fuel from one place to the other, that is an aspect. Running of the vehicles on roads, that's an aspect. Now they leave an impact on the environment. Now an impact may be positive or negative, but the way it is going to affect the environment, that will be known as the impact on the environment. So impact is nothing but how the aspect is impinging the environment. That means how it is affecting the environment, that is the impact. Now, once we have to identify, look at all the activities of the organization and identify the various aspects and the related impacts. So we have to put them in a tabular form. And once we have identified all the activities, I mean, you don't have to leave anything from the very basic activity till the end of the process or handing over of the product. All whatever activities are involved, we have to review those activities and identify the aspects. That means, what are the activities, products or services in those processes which may affect the environment. So those are the aspects. Now, with the relate to the various aspects, there may be several impacts. One aspect may have several impacts. So we have to put it in a tabular form. Identify the aspects and then identify the impacts relating to that aspect. For example, running of the DG set. Now, running of the DG set means there is exhaust gas coming out and that is polluting the air. So it is causing air pollution. So the impact is air pollution. Now, DG set, while it is running, it's also making noise. So it is polluting the environment by way of making noise. So sound pollution is taking place. And there may be certain spillages from the DG set, and those spillages may be causing the ground to get polluted. And therefore, it is again another impact. So we have to identify all the impacts related to every aspect. Now, once the aspect and impacts have been identified, then the impacts have to be categorized. Now you have to identify every aspect and impact with some kind of a rating, risk rating. So you have to identify whether the risk rating is low or risk rating is high, because wherever the risk rating is high, those aspects and impacts we are supposed to take care. But please remember, the aspects and impacts which we have identified, we have a choice to pick up those where we have the technology available, we have the expertise available, and we have the funds available to control them. Only thing is, in any aspects, wherever there is a legal requirement associated, then we have to comply with that. So all aspects and impacts where legal requirements are specified, those aspects and impacts have got to be taken care. But out of the remaining aspects and impacts, we can make a choice which aspect and impact we want to take into consideration and which ones we will take up later. So in the next video we are going to talk about how to classify these into low impact and very high impact and this kind of analysis. So we will be talking about this in the next video. So please keep watching my videos and do subscribe so that you get an indication when the next video is released. So thank you all.